Keith?
I believe it's somewhere exotic. That's what I'm going to guess.
It looks hot, doesn't it? It looks hot.
It does. It does. And well, that is the voice center of the track too.
Sorry, man. And it looks yes, lots of lakes around here. It's very nice indeed. Lots of expensive yachts as well. Looks like an expensive place to live. And that's the voice of Keith Barrick today. He's joining me in the booth once again. Hello to all our viewers. And we are currently in qualifying, so we'll jump straight into that, shall we? Drivers are just about to start their hot laps. Let's see who is on their hot laps at the moment. Toby Davis has been setting the pace during practice so far. He's looking very strong, isn't he, Keith?
Oh, very strong. He was going out there practicing with fuel. You could definitely tell he's got the pace down with the fuel in. But then he goes and takes the fuel out and just smashes the field. He had a phenomenal lap. He was up 6 tenths on second place until Chris Butcher nearly took the top spot of practice from him. But they're low 52s is what we should expect here.
25s.
Sorry, and 25s.
Yeah. 52s would be not very good for Toby Davis.
Yeah, no.
And as I say, this is a fictional track, very, very difficult track, lots and lots of curved braking zones, as you can see. Is it the sort of track you think you would like to drive on, Keith, or is it one of those you try to avoid?
I was working with Adam Vaughn pre-race, just giving him a little bit of help. It looks like a fun, flowing track. I guess it's just a matter of your combination between the car, your driving style, and this type of track. And there's a lot of guys that seem to have it down may not have had the best results this season that are stepping up and really doing well. Nice lap by Toby there to start.
25.8 from Toby, which is a good banker, but it's Jesper Torborg who is fastest at the moment. He's back in the pits, just past him. Purple at the moment is Chris Butcher. Chris Butcher's been on fire in pre-practice. Toby's been very perplexed by his pace. He's determined to get ahead of him in pre-practice lap times on our live race.
Oh, nice
3.55
nice
from Butcher.
Lap. That's the quickest he's gone, too. That would have put him, I think that was faster than he went in practice, too, so he managed to fix that sector 2 time. And for all those guys following, and the live racers as well, which is one of our supporters with race Touring Pro Series, you can follow all the laps and all the data is on our live racers page, which you can link off of touringproseries.com.
Can indeed. And here is William Levac. He is one of the dark horses for this race.
Yes.
If he can go through without hitting, he's got a real chance, hasn't he?
He does. Well, and that was a thing that I was looking at, is these smaller, lighter cars are going to be able to go the full race distance and keep the tires under them. But the other thing that's a big factor is that this pit lane is not that long. It's very short. So the time lost there may not be made up with the fact that you've stayed out on hard. So it's going to be an interesting strategic race today. And once we get through qualifying here, I'll go through a couple of the strategies that I spoke with our strategy master, Toby Davis, with, and let people know what they can expect to see today.
And, of course, the pit lane here has been, the speed limit even, sorry, has been increased because of the safety concerns out of that final corner. As you can see, it's very, very narrow. We haven't seen Gregory De Greef yet today, aren't we? I wonder where.
I haven't seen him on the server at all, actually. He did make it into the server at some point for practice, but he's not to be found.
And the bike stays fourth with the 26.0. Right on 26.2. Adam Vaughan has found some pace. He was struggling in pre-practice, really very frustrated at the way the car was handling. And you say you worked with him, didn't you?
Yeah, I was working with him, and then he goes out and bangs off a 26.1, like out of nowhere.
He?
I know, how dare he? How dare he?
But, and the M3 really suited that first corner, isn't it?
Look who snuck in there, Mr. Florian Strauss.
Florian Strauss. You would think that this is the type of track and the format that would suit the 635, wouldn't you?
I think we're going to see a bit more. I think we're going to see a better racing pace off those cars. Maybe not necessarily a hot lap pace, because they are fairly good on their tires. You know, they have the ability to possibly go purple for Jesper, possibly with mediums.
Let's check in with that then. And isn't that first sector where Jesper is the fastest car with that long straight, despite that fast first corner? But it's so crucial for the slower cars to get that first corner right, isn't it? Because it carries the momentum all the way down that long straight.
Yes, the small cars definitely they have a good racing advantage here because they can maintain their corner speed. Obviously, Jesper
is still purple
can
as well.
It.
Oh. Very nice. This is going to be close.
He's handling that Holden really well here, and I mean,
it looks so difficult to drive, doesn't it? Doesn't it look so unwieldy around these long corners?
He's always in a drift, it seems like, but he's handling it really well though.
Underneath the Touring Pro Series bridge, getting the power on as cleanly, as aggressively as possible.
Oh, look at that pit wall.
Someone's going to hit that, aren't they? Someone's going to hit that pit wall.
Someone's going to hit that. I'm
going to bet now it's Merval. That is pole position for Jesper Torbo. That's the fastest I've seen him go at any point. And that's, in fact, only half a tenth faster than I've seen anybody go at any point in the, the previous 2 weeks. So
very nice
that
lap.
Is throwing the gauntlet down very much, isn't it? And what
has
this man...
Yeah, it is.
His rival in the championship, what has this man got to offer him? Because this man had a 76-point lead over Torborg after two races, and now after seven races, the lead is just nine. Just nine points.
Yep. And Toby still... Toby, after his interview from the last race, he feels very confident. He still is very confident, very adamant that he is going to be winning this championship. And confidence... You do need the confidence if you're in these positions, because that can keep you composed when the pressure gets on you.
Absolutely. He wasn't very composed at Nürburgring, though, was he? He was involved in a couple of instances, one of his own making completely, and one not of his own making in the slightest. But the grief got the better of him in that last race. The grief is not here today, unfortunately.
It's a big
shame.
Very unfortunate. I was looking forward to seeing that skyline.
Very unusual not to see the grief around, actually, as well.
I know. I would notice. I would have expected him to be very quick here, because the skyline would be perfect for this type of track. It's medium speed, good grip, fairly light, good on tires. I think he would have been a big, big kink in this grid right now.
And it's annoyed a few people with their prediction games as well. I would assume.
Yeah, me too.
He's pretty much a permanent fixture in the top six of people's prediction games. And now here is Toby Davies. What has he got? Is Chris Buchtrout on the lap? He isn't. He's just gone back to the pit, so he must have. And it go that the exit here is also quite dangerous.
Very dangerous.
Right onto that first corner. So we might see a couple of incidents there as well.
It is wide enough, but I mean, as long as people are paying attention, it shouldn't be too much to
when the racing and the blood is his blood is pumping.
Oh yeah.
That was
a
beautiful drift there from Toby Davies into that first corner.
Always exciting to watch.
Second corner.
We pretty well say that every time off.
Yeah, and it's purple.
And that's in the
Yeah, exactly. That's in the sector where the Holden is probably the quickest. Because of that long straight. It goes very narrow here, look at that, and then goes wide. It's a very different technique to what I've seen from other people using.
Yeah, he's avoiding the snap.
And
Levike,
third. Levike's in the third, 25-6. That is a wonderful lap.
Very nice lap.
That is a fantastic lap from
Levike. However, we will be seeing Toby. Oh, drops the wheel.
Oh, he's pushing hard. Half a tenth down.
Yep, that's all it took, just a drop of a wheel. But this should
always pushing very, very hard indeed. There's Semchenko. Off the track ahead of him, with his lights on.
Track's very very warm too, 32 degrees already in qualifying.
Powers out of the final corner, now look very tired here, not sure it was quick enough to take pole, but will it take quick enough? We'll soon find out.
Second place?
Second place it is, 25.5 dead. Just squeezes in.
Oh,
so the top three cut by less than a tenth once again. We saw this closeness at Nürburgring.
We did.
That was
a
very tight track. Ooh. Collision in the pits there. Semchenko's had a bit of contact with something. Yes, but Torborg's out on track at the moment. He's about to finish one of his hot laps.
Trying to bank it. It doesn't look purple, though, so I think he's...
How hard he's pushing to that final corner.
I think there's going to be a lot of screaming moments in that corner, especially when we're...
5-0-6. Still be good enough for second place if he tried that again, so...
It's very very consistently quick with Jesper, but I mean he showed his pace, and obviously Jesper is probably one of my fan favorites, so he does get a little bit of my praise just from the years of racing with him. So for all the haters who don't like me complimenting Jesper, they can just
I'm not sure people hate it. Keith, it's not quite the right word to use.
Well, I did get an angry fan mail from from someone. We won't name names, but Jesper's a great racer, hands down, and pretty well a lot of these guys. I mean, they all get my praise. Everyone that races in Touring Pro Series does, because you know it's a passion for everyone to the end. But we all have our favorites, so simple as that.
I'm sure the viewers have their favorites as well. Whichever your favorite driver is, let us know in the chat box, and we'll try and get a few morsels of TV coverage for them.
Yep,
there's
lots
of love for Pink Power and Eric Tveit, who are not necessarily always at the front of the field, but lots of love for them. They are characters. People
watch them. Well, the Eric Tveit fan club, I haven't quite seen them in the chat yet, but I know they're probably watching. But if anyone in the chat box is looking to get some coverage from someone, just post it up. We'll see if we can get them on the screen and see if we can catch them in the middle of a heated battle.
There is Florence Strauss. He was absent from Nürburgring, which is a shame, because that was his home track, technically, for the WTM.
It was.
Under the TPS bridge.
We were
going to come to the line. I don't think it's going to be improved, though. Go ahead, Keith.
I was just discussing with Toby Davis actually before the race regarding Florian's pace for Laca, because this track has a very it's probably in equalizing the cars is very similar to Virginia International Raceway VIR, and where you saw these guys battling at the front. They weren't necessarily the quickest in qualifying, but when it came down to race time, Strauss, Berlaca, we also had Yunus Ravio, who is, I don't believe, is with us again today. Won't be with for the season, right, I believe?
Yeah, we are missing a lot of the Scandinavian contingents that started the season. Now that Rasmus Salo has gone, we've lost quite a few of those guys, unfortunately. But never mind.
But you know, I think Toby's got it right, though. I think when the qualifying pace isn't gonna determine the who's gonna be there in the race. The you know Strauss has endless amounts of racing experience, and I think he'll be a factor in this because it's not just gonna be a walk away. I don't think here. I think everyone's gonna be close. People are gonna be making moves, and we could see a surprise win. Maybe William Levesque go Canada.
That would be wonderful if we see Levesque win a race. He's been proven all throughout the year, hasn't he, Keith? I mean, we saw him in the V8s. He was in server 2 to begin with.
Yes.
And then he got himself into server 1. And not a good time there from Toby Davis, who spins out.
Well, maybe we could do a quick
Chris
rundown
Butcher
through the field.
Didn't work either. Oh. He didn't do anything. He's been talking on an outlap, so here we are. Some run to the field, as Keith said. Levesque's been improving throughout the season, though, hasn't he? I'm really, really impressed throughout the year. And now into 2012, of course, now. I think I always forget that. But he started off in V8s, and he ended up getting a couple of top fives in the V8s in the end as well. On difficult tracks, you know, like Sydney and Surfers Paradise. Those are hard tracks. And I've been very impressed with his improvement and maturity throughout the 2011 and now into 2012, of course.
Yeah, definitely. And he's also joined in for ATCC after seeing a broadcast, which is good. Unfortunately, you know, a little into the season, so he may have to wait a few races before he can get a spot.
We do have a bit of a waiting list that series, don't we?
Yeah, we do. And, I mean, it's great that, you know, the drivers from one league see the potential in another, and they join up and you know, could end up potentially racing in all of the Touring Pro Series leagues and really showcasing their talents. So,
absolutely.
But, it looks like it's going to be good all the way through the field because there's not monster gaps between the specific, like the groups of cars.
No, you see the top 11, all 26 is look.
And it's
and Lennon just jumps into server.
Oh, nice. Okay, good. I saw Gary
very late
earlier.
He's not been able to set a lap time, unfortunately.
And anybody who's Ben Davis was late.
Ben Davis was late as well. He says he's been in court all day, so I don't know what he's been doing. He's been a naughty boy, obviously. No, just kidding. He's obviously been a witness in some sort.
Just a witness.
Maybe it's for... Maybe it was for his bad driving.
Yeah, maybe.
And as Nahi is 11th, I would have thought he would like to get just a... Oh, look at that. He just improved by 10th and he's gone into top 8. As Nahi. That's how close it is at the moment. Jeff Domming also is in that boat. He's improved by just over a 10th and he will get into that top 8.
I know, it's so tight there.
13th place is his Toyota partner in crime, Mikko Mustonen. We do love that Toyota. It can be... It's often criticised for being a bit slow, but I kind of like the car.
And it's, I like it too.
It's very, very lusty sounding as well. As we go on board with it. No, it's one of the nicest sounding cars in the field. Screams away that 3-liter turbo V6, which is hopelessly uncompetitive. Uncompetitive. Yes, that's word. That's the word. in real life, it was that they failed completely. They only got like 350 brake horsepower out of it, even though it's a 3-liter V6 turbo. When a 2-liter four-cylinder turbo Sierra RS500 managed to get 550. So obviously they needed better engine tuners back in their day. And Mirvold pops up to 9th, so that makes it even closer. Lee Palmer, 15th, Peter Clausen, 16th. 17th is Nathnahi, 18th here is Ilivanov, 19th is Yara Vinari, our master of videos. See, I was going to say something else then. I say master of commander, that's not the work, is it?
Maybe you can hop to Gary, because he's actually, I think he made it out for one lap.
Oh, I'm not, it's 0 now, so where is Gary?
I think you know. I think he's already on track. He's not going to make it.
No, he's not
going to
make it. No,
very
he's already on 0 now, and he's going to find the corner.
Oh, I believe our pole sitter and winner of 3 points is going to be the Iceman.
Is it 3 points or is it 2?
2 points. It should be 3.
I can't remember.
I'm sorry, I made the prediction game. I'm thinking prediction game. My mistake.
I'll just double check for me. It could be 3 points anyway, but I think it's 2 because. I award less points for normal qualifying, but it seems, yes, we're talking some pole. Yes, because there's two main rivals. three main rivals, I guess you could say, with the Vag as well, are in the pits. So, fantastic effort there from Jasper Torborg. Wow. That was not expected at all. I thought Davis or Butcher would definitely get pole position.
Exactly. I think he just pulled out the bag. Butcher.
Yeah, that's his absolute PB, I think.
It is, and he did it at the right time, too. I mean, Toby was very close to it, but he just couldn't quite squeeze that last little bit. And it shows that these three guys are literally on that very far edge of the car's ability. I mean, they're within how far? What's the distance? 1.116?
Less than that.
No, not even. Less than that.
Yeah, less than a tenth. Less than a tenth around this fairly long and technical circuit as well.
Yeah, and different cars, too. I mean,
then be left on track as well. No, I think everybody's back in the pits. Yes, they are. We've seen lots of pictures of pit buildings. And yes, but Gary Lennon's out on track, but he won't be able to set this lap time. Although it is letting him carry on, isn't it? I wonder if he's going to be kind. We might get away with it, look. Oh, it almost hit the... Oh, no, it didn't. Oh, that is... that is just teasing, that is.
Oh, that is such a tease.
Anyway, unfortunately, Gary will have to start from the back of the grid, but I'm sure he's got the pace. And he'll enjoy coming back through the field, I'm sure. He's that type of driver. He loves his racing. Absolutely loves his racing.
He does.
But congratulations, Jesper Torborg.
Yeah, well done.
He closes the gap on Toby Davis even more at the top of the standings.
Yes,
for pole position.
I am just looking at it right now, so you just go through the grid. I'll tell you in a moment.
It will be an information. So, front row, Torborg and Davis. Second row, Butcher and the Vike. So it's Torborg, Davis and Butcher at the front of the field once again, as they have been for much of the season. Fifth place is Strauss. Sixth place is Balaka. Those 6-3-5s are lurking on row three. Seventh is Eric Tavares. Eighth is Adam Vaughan. He'll be pleased with eighth place, considering how much he was struggling in pre-practice before this event. Ninth place, David Jones. Tenth place, Olimarias Meervold. 11th place, JIG. 12th place, Alberto Asnahi. So Alberto loses out in the BMW stakes this time around, but he does beat his brother once more. He must be sick of that, Ricardo. 13th place, Ricardo. He's less than a tenth behind as well, the poor guy.
I know, it's literally half a tenth.
14th place, Jeff Dobbing in the end. Shows how much people improved, actually, because it was a 26.9 to get to 9th, and now it's a 26.9 to get to 12th, so people really improved in the final few minutes. Mussen in there in 15th. So the two Toyota Supras together as well. So the two brothers and the two Toyota Supras. 16th place is Lee Palmer. 17th place is Peter Clausen. 18th place, Ilivano. 19th place, Yari Venari. 20th, Adam Egby. We've got some fast drivers out at the back of the field.
I know. Very interesting.
Look for some fireworks back there. Mottram in 21st. 22nd was Tony Matthews. 23rd, Jonathan Asiklint. 24th, Joachim Schaustad. Ben Davis in 25th. He managed to get one lap in. Well done to him, actually, because he's had very limited time. 26th, Vanisinchenko, who I don't think has got into the 106%, unfortunately, so he will not be able to race.
Well, now, what about Gary Lennon, though?
He has shown, obviously, it's a dispensation, and shown he has the pace in previous pre-practice.
Yes. Yeah, actually, that's right. He was on the server earlier, and that's what showed in the live racers. So he had a pace of a 26.2. Gary actually showed a pace of.
He did
127 laps of practice leading up to this on this server. Oh, so very unfortunate that he showed up late and he's going to have to start at the back. But I would expect to see a very interesting race, and hopefully, if he has a good race, we can talk to him after.
Yeah, hopefully. He'll be able to watch some shenanigans, I'm sure.
And just to point out, the gap between in the championship hunt now is 7 points between Jesper and Toby. And for a win to a second is 10 points. So we could very well see whoever finishes ahead of the other. If Jesper finishes ahead of Toby, he will be leaving here with the championship lead if he's finishing in the top five at this race.
There will be no formation out for this event, by the way. There is supposed to be. But
so we're just going to go straight to it.
The admin decided that it wasn't going to be a formation lap.
Yes. And, admin.
If you'd like to talk to the people, Keith, anything you've got to talk about. You're the strategy to talk about, right? You've got 2 minutes, quick.
I just want to let everyone know, okay, what we can expect to see here today for strategy-wise, it's pretty straightforward. The heavier cars, Holden, Sierras, Nissan, Skyline, unfortunately we don't have one, The Rovers are going to, the potential for them is going to be hards at the first stint, hards in the second stint. That's the most likely of scenarios for these guys. And all of these strategies came as a from Toby Davis, our strategy master, who definitely takes the time to learn these things. Now, the cars that can get away with hards all race, which could very well be a game-winning strategy, is the Mercedes, BMW M3s, and the Alphas. William Levaik probably has a bit of an advantage if he's able to go. Now, the other option is for some of the mid-sized cars, the 635s, the Sierras, and the mid-speed cars that we have in the WTM mod, could possibly go with a medium tire to start and hards at the in the second stint. The only problem with going with the medium tire at the start is if you end up in battle in some type of battle with another car and you're really pushing to either get a spot or defend a spot, you're going to burn the tires up within the first 5 to 6 laps, and then you'll be overheated, and you're going to kill your first stint and lose a ton of time for heading into the last stint with the hards, and you'll probably have to pit early, and it'll kill you also at the end of the stint. Now, the other option is lesser fuel to start the race. If someone feels they can get away with lesser fuel at the start and possibly break from the field, maybe Jesper, maybe Toby, maybe Chris, they may be able to get out front and gap themselves from the field, take the fuel when they come in for their stop, when they take their tires, but they run the risk of running the lighter fuel and potentially being on the medium tires and just hurting the car, racing so hard with other people. You need to be guaranteed to get yourself a gap if you're going to be going with the lesser fuel. So starting with full fuel, you can basically set your strategy as the race progresses. You would know what you're going to be doing. If you've got a gap, if you're able to save your tires, you can actually just take your time and not pit and possibly go the whole race. So those are the strategies we can look to see. I think we're headed into the race now.
Thank you for that rundown, Keith.
Call that off.
Yep. And there'll be no formation update. Get straight to the action. And I'm looking forward to that turn one, which is quite narrow, but it's not any really braking zone. So hopefully we won't see any shenanigans into there. No shenanigans. Hopefully people will all behave themselves, of course.
Yes, everyone behave.
Here is the pole hitter in his big Holden.
His big Holden. He's holding the pole. That was awful. Well, famous words.
They are. They have been spoken.
We have 9 seconds to count down here. No formation lap. 3, 2, 1. We're going to be seeing the lights and we're going to be taking off here. Call him, Ryan.
And away from the grid they go. Oh, Paul's been left from the grid. He's been left from the grid completely. Butcher and Davis are screaming away from him. Levike's even passing off the grid. Balaka's going through as well. We've seen how good his starts can be. Balaka, Davis, Butcher and...
Where's Strauss?
Levike have all gone through. Strauss is back into around about 9th position, I think. No, that's Dwight. Where is Strauss? There he is. Back,
Strauss
way
is
back.
In 9th position.
And Myhrvold is hassling Vaughan as well. Down into the first corner, though. Second corner, though, they come. And up the inside from Balaka. Davis is being challenged by Butcher.
Wow.
Look on board with these two now. And there's Balaka around the outside of Levaik. Great move there from Bonnie's lap. He's so good in the opening lap. So good indeed.
He is.
And away from the field he gets. And back to fifth.
Oh, Tommy,
here is the championship leader. The second place in the championship. Pole sitter back to fifth. That's a disaster for Torborg.
It is, especially when he gained those 2 points. He just gave them all away.
He did. Oh, and Davis is wide. He's sideways. He managed to recover it, though. Butcher is looking threatening, though.
Oh, but
Balaka,
you know what?
Third already. Look at the start of him.
Look at the pace.
The start from Balaka.
See, this is what could be happening. He may think, I got to get to the front. He might be on mediums with low fuel, knowing that if he gets track position, like we'll know more as the race goes on. But this is showing incredible pace.
Incredible pace early on. He is a great driver as well on those cold tires.
Fantastic.
And Torborg's got past Levaik on the little short shoot back straight. So he's up to fourth already. And this is where he needs to just knuckle down.
He's not making it easy on himself. That's the thing. I mean, you've seen this. How many races in a row now? He's got it. Like, I'd be spending the time learning the start.
Starts off poor. There's no doubt about it.
Well, But the bike
is getting closer to the top of the field. I think these guys are definitely very nervous. Butcher is hassling and harrying his friend Toby Davis, absolutely hassling him, and it's compromising all their pace.
It
and
is.
Balaka is hooking the grass on the inside there as well.
Love it.
Let's go and ball with Balaka and watch this battle. That's actually Tallbog. We'll watch Tallbog actually, because that's the best position to watch from. Oh, Balaka, why is that our party's pushing? How can you go wide there? It's a flat-out corner.
Davis looks always locked up. I can never understand how he keeps his car together when he locks up like that all the time.
It can't 100% be good.
Break.
It can't be good for the tyres. Back in the field, Vaughan and Myhrvold having a bit of a battle. They no love lost from Norris Ring between those two.
Nope.
And
Vaughan
is trying to give
not.
A bit of a tuk-tuk to Myhrvold, but then he comes to the straight and Myhrvold just powers away and frustrates Vaughan
once Strauss
again.
And Florian Strauss is trying to get by too. Strauss just makes his way by Adam Vaughan for eighth position.
He does indeed. So Vaughan.
Nice move.
Strauss up to ninth.
Sorry.
And Vaughan's facing back. Oh, there's contact there. Wide on the gravel they go. I would go to that, but the battle at the front is getting even closer.
It is very close at the front. We're just watching two screens here. But
and look who's tagging onto the back of the group. Eric Tveit. Great
Tveit.
Start. And here is Paul Levesque as well.
Where's the Eric Tveit fan club?
It better be in full force here today, because look at the speed that Levesque can carry through there compared to the Rover. Look at that.
Levesque using a little too much curb through there. He's going to lose some exit speed. Someone dropped the wheel.
Here we go again.
Look at Toby
and Davis. Oh, he's almost contact there. That was a huge swerve out.
Oh, he's going
around the outside.
No.
It's so difficult to do that there.
It's such a long corner, I think.
Is he going to do it?
Is Davis going to give him the room?
He's not giving him the room.
He thought better of it.
That is great driving from both of them. Just needs to be patient. Just needs to get past right now. Just needs to make Davis make a mistake. And that is one of the ways you can get to Davis, isn't it? Just pressure him.
A lot of pressure. And you know what? I mean, these guys practiced together for this race. They were on the server. They did... Chris and Toby Davis did the most laps of anybody. They did almost 300 laps apiece leading up to this event. So these are the guys. These guys know exactly what they need to do in the race. But I know that Butcher wants to win. He wants to win. He wants to carry on his momentum. He got his first win at the last WTM event. Look at this battle.
Look at this battle. This is unbelievable.
I love seeing the Supra. I love it.
The Supra. It's a Supra and a Ford. Sierra sandwiched by two M3s. And around the outside, trying to go Asnahi on Dobbing. That'd be a great move if he could pull it off. He is pulling it off. Oh, contact. He just squeezes across. Vaughan to the head of this. He was actually back behind a couple of his drivers. Fastest lap from Jesper Torbo, 26.735.
Yep.
Both of them sending fastest laps on that lap, because I think Balaka actually flashed up there for a second also as well. Look at this. The front of the field, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. You throw a blanket over them. You really could. Davis, Butcher, Balaka, Sierra, 635, Holden.
This is a great battle. I love this track for what it's doing, bringing the cars equal like this. You know, you got pretty well every car in the top 10 almost.
Absolutely. And here's Balaka. He's pushing so hard. What he doesn't want, though, is to be held up at one point by these guys and just have Talbot blast past him down the straight. That's the big worry, isn't it?
Exactly, and that's the last thing he wants.
Oh, Butcher!
Look, I don't
wiggling around.
So you got Butcher's wiggling, Toby's locked up. These guys, they're like we always pretty well say every race. They're so exciting to watch.
They are
so exciting to watch.
And Davis, very different line to Butcher through there. It's very wide. Was Butcher keeps nice tight line? Have you noticed that?
Yeah, very tight. Oh, look at that. Oh, look, he just...
Balaka can gain on those curved braking zones. The 635 just handles so well through there.
Yeah, I think Toby said his biggest threat, possibly to hit both him and Butcher, was the 635.
Oh, he's got a great run here now, Balaka, as well. He's in the slipstream. Just difficult to make a pass in that 635.
But he
on these cars, I have more... Fastest lap.
Balaka.
Fastest lap from both of them at the same time.
All
was that an equal fastest lap?
I'll tell you in a second here.
Is it 249
just,
each?
No, Davis just did a... Okay, it's a little
328,
delayed here.
328, sorry, I'm getting all excited. Don't have time to read it, because Balaka just eclipsed him immediately. 26.2 from Balaka, so he's got the fastest lap.
Yes, he does. He's scored himself some extra...
Davis, so wise. So sideways, sorry. This is Balaka's best performance since Virginia.
It is. Yes, it is.
And Tolbuck's not really on the back of this group. He's just keeping watching brief.
Remember, we also have
Balaka every time through there.
Yeah, Jesper doesn't quite have the race pace right now. Every time they go into this corner, we just lose the cars because of the smoke off of Toby's tires.
And Butcher's doing the same thing as well.
just at the back, a little bit further back in 7th place, Florian Strauss has got by Almarius Myhrvold, the pink machine. We don't need to show. I just wanted to give people the update there. But obviously, people
there's
can follow along.
There's a battle
between
Levi and Tveit, and that's coming back towards Strauss. So it's definitely a top four battle here, because this is the battle for 5th.
It is,
Tveit and Strauss will be with them in no time at all,
I think he was held up by Myhrvold there for a little bit, and it's not easy to... We know from the whole season that it's not easy to pass those Holdens.
And how would you... yes, it's definitely not easy to pass those Holdens at all.
No,
how would you feel if
you
had Strauss zoning in on you?
I'd be a little nervous, right? Well, I mean, it's more so that
you're Butcher makes a mistake! Butcher's going to go wide! Balaka's going to get the pass, but he's not going to be able to carry the momentum properly because Butcher has the power and sticks his foot down. This is the problem! Here comes Torborg, who's got the power. And Balaka's desperately trying to stay in the slipstream and get the...
Is he got it?
The braking.
No.
He can't hold it.
He can't hold it down the inside.
Surely he's going to be able to do it.
I don't think he can hold it because there's so much grip on that 635. No.
Oh, beautiful.
He can't. The 635 has so much grip. So much grip on the outside.
He knew he had to do it, didn't he?
Yeah, he knew it.
He knew he had to do it.
He can't. If he knew if he gave that spot up, he's not getting it back.
Yes, yeah, absolutely.
Balaka is very smart. I can't see the car.
He's drinking.
The inside.
Balaka held up again.
Not quite.
Two mistakes in this lap so far. Is the pressure we're going to tell on him? And Davis has been immaculate since the opening lap.
All four of these drivers are under pressure right now. Like, even Jesper's under pressure to make a move because he knows he's got to get through there because Davis is starting to gap the field. He doesn't want that. That's who he needs to get to.
Cannot let Davis get away at all.
And Butchie's just got to calm down a little bit, regroup, get in the draft, and catch Toby.
That gap is as big as it's ever been, isn't it?
It is. It is. And that's, we've said it all season long. Toby, if he has free air, he can get away. And, I mean, he made the rare mistake at Nürburgring. Last event, but we don't want to. It's not a common thing. And look at this battle here.
Tveit's got past the Vike now. There's aggression through there. Tveit's made a mistake.
Tveit's made a mistake.
It's gone wide. Oh, the Vike tried to cut back, but it made his car go sideways. And look who's zoning in. Florian Strauss, our World V8 Supercars 2011 champion, right behind these two guys.
He is.
And they know how quick he is. Because they've raced against him in both series, both WTM and V8.
Well, we've all seen the inspirational video of Florian Strauss and how he came through and won
side
that championship.
Side.
I know.
Side by side. No one's giving it an inch.
Will the Vike be able to get enough
power to get a run down the inside of the braking zone?
He's going for it. Over to the inside.
The French is getting through. Great pass.
Nice move.
Great pass. And he knew Strauss was there as well. He just decided to go for it. And Tveit gave him plenty of room also, which is very nice indeed. Great run from all of them.
Very good racing. Jesper lost a little time because I was watching. He made an attempt on the outside of Berlaka where he was able to hold his car. The Holden's too heavy to hold the outside of that corner. There's no banking. It's perfectly flat. Mm-hmm. There was no way he was going to make that stick.
Just loads up the tires as you go around,
doesn't
it?
Yes.
Further and further.
It's so hard on the tires. It just eats them up. Now.
The lap time's down 27.1 from Toby on the last lap. What's it this time around? 26.5. So just a slow lap time from slow lap time from all of them last time around. Because, in fact, Toby gapped the field last lap around, didn't they? So it's very interesting indeed.
Just a quick update. Gary Lennon is up to 19th position.
Very nice.
Very good
from
run.
Lennon.
He's just making a move by Ilovanov right now.
Not in 26th, remember?
Yeah, 26th. So he's probably our biggest gainer so far. Yeah, no. Well, he has practice, but he didn't get a chance.
Butcher's right on Davis once again. Look at this. Right on him once again. We thought maybe Davis was gapping, but Butcher's managed to get in that draft and just close the gap up once again.
Florian Strauss tried to make a move up the inside of Tveit, and Tveit just closed the door. It's funny because you see Eric gives all the room to Levi, and then Strauss goes up the inside. He kneels. He's like, I don't think I'm going to get back by him. I'm not giving it up.
And they come below the TPS bridge, and Myhrvold's catching this battle now, look, because they're all battling.
Oh, yeah.
Here comes Myhrvold. And
it's that type
Adam
of Vaughan
as well.
Yep.
Bugging away and just following. Just get away from that little battle they had before. They were all children at play, weren't they? Oh!
Yes.
And Strauss, very out of shape, almost hit the back of Eric Tveit. Maybe Tveit was out of shape, and that caused him to go out of shape.
We're going to be doing 41 laps here, guys. So we're only on lap 8.
We're on lap 8.
I mean, we're going to start to see people's
tires
go off. We're gonna start to see people.
Tall Pog's pushing hard.
Oh man, I really don't want to see that happen to anybody, especially someone running like Jesper in the championship hunt.
Oh, Dave, Butcher and Davis have different lines through there. Very different lines throughout the whole of the track, actually, for Butcher
whole,
and Davis.
The
noticed.
Whole field. Everyone seems to have a little bit of a different line. Levesque has now gapped himself from Eric Tveit.
Oh, Butcher sideways on the brakes. It's not going to help his tire life at all.
I love this battle here. This is phenomenal.
This is a wonderful battle. It really is. Davis pushing so hard. Going to compromise this section here as well.
Yep. He's going to lose momentum. Look,
gained
he's closing
on
right.
By Butcher. Oh,
going into
will
a heavy
track
momentum.
No, not quite. Oh, not locking up as much this time around.
Toby's all over the track. Butcher sideways too. Oh.
Over the curbs. Oh, Balaka! You can carry. Oh, a touch there for Balaka.
Just
letting
a little
know
kiss.
That he's there.
Just a little kiss.
I'm still here. He's saying I'm still here.
And Florian Strauss has got by Eric Tveit up into sixth position after having a horrendous start, dropping back to ninth.
Yes,
so now he's got Levesque. But remember, he can run the whole race on the one set of tires if he manages them.
The problem is, though, he's been fighting through the field. So
I know.
Perhaps that's ruined his tires.
I don't think that the only person I would say that could potentially do this if he keeps his tires together is Levesque that up in the front right now.
I think perhaps Balaka could do it.
Yeah. He doesn't seem to be out of shape at any time, really, does he?
I've never seen lock up his brakes once, I don't think. Oh, he almost into the back of Butcher there as well. He must be getting so frustrated by that corner. And now he's under attack. He must go to the inside this time. He does. He doesn't use the slipstream.
Oh, but he's
before.
Got it. Oh, look.
Torborg
yes,
is past him
he's
on
gone.
The track. It's gone through.
Gone.
Oh, see, Balaka's, that was Balaka's biggest fear.
Yes.
Being
yes.
held up behind. But, oh, and Butcher's gone wide. Oh, and Balaka almost drills the back of Torborg.
But there's
as
a
well.
Very good. There's a very good chance, though, now, because Jesper, if he can keep close on the back of... If he can keep close on the back of Butcher, he can get a run on him, make a move, and then Balaka could possibly go by the both of them.
Here is Joachim Schausdad. He is going to be lapped by the field. So will this throw a spanner in the works?
He should. He should notice it and probably just clear the way.
Absolutely. But you've got four guys charging up on you. It's pretty difficult to let them all pass all at once, right?
Yes,
who's going to lose out?
Who is going to? Oh no! He's
pulled right
over. Great move.
Well, right over. All four to go past. That was a perfect place to do it as well. Very well done to him.
Yeah. That move on Jesper's part, like that was. It wasn't just all power. It started with Butcher getting a little loose, Balaka trying to take advantage, and then he lost his momentum and his run coming off that corner down a long straight where Jesper just nice to floats himself around the corner, uses the draft of him, and then used the Butcher draft and just pulled by on the outside. No, Balaka never had a chance.
Problem with Balaka now, he's going to be even more frustrated in the corners because the Holden's even slower than the Sierra.
Exactly.
Look at this. Wow. Torborg's right and Butcher. He's come alive. He has come alive. This could be the move, you know, because he has the power. He has the slipstream.
Look at the speed.
Will Butcher go defensive? No, he doesn't. Oh, he does. They both got last second. Torborg muscles his way down the inside.
Oh, Butcher.
Oh, he's so close to Butcher. Oh, that was hard racing.
That was hard racing. It was good.
That was borderline, very much indeed. That was a big crash.
He made his move, but might have been a little late.
Yeah, he was waiting for Torborg to make his move, wasn't he? You know what it is? You look behind you, and make your move immediately when the other guy does. That's very, very risky indeed.
It is. And Davis, again, locking up the brakes. Butcher's got a nice line through there. He's going to get a run on Davis.
See, the Holden's supposed to have a higher tyre wear than the Sierra, but we saw at Nürburgring that Torborg was able to keep the car together for longer periods than the Sierra, it seems.
Yes.
And it seems like that here today.
Go to Adam Braun. Position 8. He just got flipped by Myhrvold.
Ball back on.
Spinning around
in the gravel. Get back on track.
Here, let's see if you can pull that back. Oh, my goodness.
Here we go.
Oh, look at this. You got Myhrvold.
What is Myhrvold doing?
He locks
here
up.
Here we are.
And look at this. They send him over slow-mo. Oh, it did. Oh, it showed a flip on my screen. His car actually went up and over. Like
that was just a mistake from Myhrvold, actually. Really, it wasn't anything.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, nothing intentional.
Too sinister.
It wasn't anything intentional. No ill will there. But
I thought it was dived on the inside at first. My apologies to Myhrvold.
No. I just said on my screen, his car actually went up and over and flipped.
Oh, go back to normal, thank you.
Yeah.
And Strauss now caught Levesque as well. Oh, and other front of the field. Here we are. Once again, almost carbon copy of before. Look at these three, so close. Balaka's dropped off as well.
Yeah, he's dropped up his pace.
You know what? Just slightly put out by that
Well, here's another theory. He could I'm throwing a theory out there. If he is planning to do the whole race on one set of tires, and he notices his tire wear is fairly high, he may very well just say, "All right, I'm going to slow it down a bit. I'm not going to push as hard." Oh yes, we're.
Look at the leaping over the curb there from Chris Butch. That was a superb shot. Very well done to the cameraman.
Oh not wow. But no, it was just if he is planning to do a full race on one set of tires, by slowing his pace down a little bit and maybe gapping off a little bit, letting the tires cool down, he can save them more so he can get through this whole race. Because
he's been passed anyway, right?
Hard. So yeah, he's been passed. So just wait it out. Just keep your distance. These guys are going to pit. There's no doubt about it. They have to pit.
The corners are just far too long and far too demanding on the tires.
On those particular cars. And Florian Strauss is...
He struggles at that final corner, doesn't he, Talbot?
He does, yeah.
He can't really use the pace as much as he would like to, as much as you would think he would be able to use it. Just get a decent run through there.
Yeah, it's a... Well, if his tires are definitely going off from this battling. I mean, he struggled to get back to a spot that he should be in. He was our pole sitter. And it seems to be the way things have gone this season for Jesper. Gets
he's not a good start.
Well.
Four
off the line, and then has to race his way back. And he showed good pace, but you know you don't cripple yourself at the start of an event. You know it doesn't make sense to do so.
Apologies there for the shoddy camera work.
But just noticing the back there, Miravol, Jay Adji, David Ewent are in a three-way battle side by side.
Let's have a look at the back of that then. This battle at the front seems to be
ninth and tenth. I'll follow the leaders just so you can follow that.
Blanking you. And here is the battle.
Jay Adji just got by him.
This is David Ewent. He's right behind Pink Power.
Yep.
And after that incident, Vaughan's back in 12th, so he's back behind his M3 rival Asnahi. He's actually sandwiched by the Asnahi brothers.
I think that was the same thing at Nürburgring, wasn't it?
Alberto actually took him out at the first corner in the first race, so there's not much love between the M3 brothers.
No. They may be in the same car, but...
Nope. No love lost at all.
Oh, and so David Ewent is looking to get by Mirabal here.
Mirabal looks like he's struggling with his tyres.
Yes,
he does. Drop back. He's charged forward at first. He's like... up and like challenged for that eighth position, but now he's dropping further and further behind.
Back to the leaders. Davis has gone defensive, very defensive. Down the inside.
Oh, here we go.
Jesper.
Here we go.
Is he going to do it around the outside?
Oh, Butcher! Will he do it this time? Will Torbjörn take advantage of anything? It's side by side through the second turn. Who will yield? Will any of them yield? No, neither of them yield. And it ends with Butcher being just pushed slightly to the edge of the track. And the lead stays with Toby.
Jeez, these guys are just... Wow.
They're playing for keeps.
They are. And you know, Chris is racing to prove that he should be in the championship hunt. He's had some, you know, unfortunate races at the start of the season. But, you know, to pull his first race win off ever in World Touring Masters last event at Nürburgring, he wants to carry that momentum, you know.
That was his 50th TDS race as well, where he finally got his WTM win.
Wow. That's phenomenal. But you know what? If he can,
Butcher sideways. Sorry, Keith, carry on.
No, it's okay. No, if he can finish this season off with a couple of wins, I think he's going to be one of the top contenders for the start of next season. Definitely, because he's got the pace. You know, his struggle with in season two was always that he just seemed to have a little bit of meltdowns, and he's calmed down quite a bit.
So, he's making a mistake at that first turn very often.
Oh, Davis
wide as well. Now it's going to be on.
Yep.
Here we are, on board with Torborg, watching this battle. This game, not close to taking advantage of any shenanigans.
I think he's Davis. Clear. I think he's clear.
No, he's not. Still side by side. He's exactly the same as the lap before. Oh, there's contact. Halfway through the corner this time.
Oh,
Davis
Butcher,
just trying desperately to hold his line. Butcher's trying to cut back. It's not happening.
Mirabal
into the pits. That's very early indeed.
Unless he started on a medium stopper. Maybe he started on mediums to get some track position, but that's not the best strategy. Florian Strauss into fifth as well. Look at these guys, they're just
Butcher sideways. Very well held drift that was.
Oh wow. And we're only at lap 14. Like I'm exhausted. I'm exhausted. This is phenomenal.
Not even halfway through the race.
Not even
when will these boys stop battling? I want to rest.
Why stop battling? It was 35 degrees. The track temperature is now 35 degrees. So these guys' tires are going off. And I mean, there is battling all around, but it seems fairly settled right now throughout the grid. Gary Lennon, 13th place.
Started 26th. Now in top half of the field.
He's made up a position a lap. Phenomenal run by Gary. I really, really hope he can keep this up. Because it's not out of the question. I'm looking at the gap right now. It is not out of the question to be in the top 10. If not, into...
maybe 8th, perhaps.
Possibly 8th. Yeah, a phenomenal run by Gary.
And once again, down the straight. It's very, very close. But this time, Davis does not feel the need to go defensive. Ooh, very sad. Oh, he's flashing his lights. He just pressed his lights by accident there, I think.
A little bit of a flash?
He was sideways in the corner. I think he just caught his lights. On board with Jesper Torborg. What is Jesper Torborg thinking right now, Keith?
Keep the car together. These guys might pull a mistake like they did in season 2. But they've shown such composure so far. With running side by side, I know Toby Davis is on a bit of a short leash with his incidents that have happened in the past. So he knows he's got to race clean, and he has been so far. I mean, they're side by side through a 180 degree long sweeping right hand corner multiple times. That's good racing. These guys.
Very good racing indeed.
These guys are keeping it together, and I don't think Jesper should bank on them making a mistake. I think he's got to come up with a game plan and say, all right. When am I going to be pitting? Do these guys look like their tires have gone off more than mine have? If I can pass them, where am I going to do it? Is it going to be early? Is it going to be late? And Gary Lennon is actually caught up to Ricardo Asnaghi, and looks like he's got the pace to go by fairly quick to take. He's in 12th because old Mirvold pitted. So
no, he's 13th still.
Sorry, my mistake. No, Ricardo.
Exactly there. But Butcher and Davis once again. Look at this once again. Oh, it's just. It's like deja vu, 50 times a race.
It is. Well, yes. See, Jesper's just calculated. I mean, he's not close enough to really do anything right now, and I don't know if that's by choice, because he knows these guys are not going to give room.
Do you get involved with these guys right now?
No, not a chance, not this early in the race. You know what? It's going to be close no matter how you look at it anyway. Oh, geez, look at these guys. Oh, and Gary Lennon into 12th, takes Asnaghi. Nice move, nice clean move.
Oh, Venari's out of the race. Venari, out of the race, unfortunately.
The guy who works so hard on our videos when he does.
Indeed.
A big thanks to Yari.
Not sure what's happened to him. Not getting damage on the car, perhaps. Some other incidents. Oh, Davis and Butcher! This is a different area of the track now.
Different spot. Different
spot. Very close indeed. And Butcher just has that slight overlap to make Davis go on a tight line that he... Oh, Davis.
Oh, man. Blocked the apex perfectly. Jesper's right there.
There's this final corner where Jesper just struggles so much with that car.
Yeah, so what we're seeing is the viewers are saying it looks like Toby's tires are gone. And, I mean, it's very well because Toby raced hard to keep the lead early on.
But he's looking up a lot as well. Look at Torborg! You just get the run through this corner. Press the right button. There we go. Torborg.
I don't think
he's not going to have the run adopted because Butch's got a perfect run off there.
No, I don't think so.
It's going to be close. He's just threatening. He's making Butch worried.
Look at the run. Yeah, worry him a little bit. Oh, Butcher, is he late move?
Oh, he's sideways! Oh, he's still sideways!
Wow!
Oh, what a hole for Butcher! What a hole! He almost cleaned out his friend and rival Toby Davis
and
then.
And championship leader. Wow!
That was an unbelievable hole.
You said it exactly. He scared him into making that little bit of a bump there. Because he came up really quick, right?
Yes.
Oh, incredible hole. Incredible.
Oh, again. Oh, Torborg's hit Butcher! Torborg has hit Butcher's contact! Butcher's sideways!
Good. He's safe.
They saved it. There's no damage, but there is a little bit of a gap lost.
Let's watch that again. Will that be decisive
for Toby Davis? Can he use that gap now?
Can we replay that? Let's see exactly what happened there.
Both of them locked up and sideways. He just clipped the back end.
It's just like the Mirvold and Vaughn incident. I think he did lift off to let him back in because...
Yes, he definitely tried to take advantage of that. Here we go. They were both sideways.
Yeah.
Just the tiniest nudge. There. Very well held from Butcher, actually. He caught the wall just a little bit. Wonder if he's got a small amount of damage. It may hurt his lap time. Oh, it's so close between these two again. There's no love lost between these two, of course. Remember Sabring. Butcher hit Torborg twice.
Yes, he did.
Clean off the track.
But no, but see, look, this Toby is absolutely loving this right now.
Yes. Exactly.
A lot of stuff
to lock
in the pits, 9.5 seconds. Well, that was a second slower than old Marius Mirval, which
and
leads
Toborg
me to believe.
On the outside of Butcher. It's not going to work. I don't think Butcher.
No, it's not going to work.
He's not fast enough. And no, Toborg is already behind or
he's
halfway to the corner.
He's got no side grip in that car. There's too much weight pushing on those sidewalls. And the tires are hot. We're like 35 degrees. But I noticed one thing. Remember we were just saying that there's a potential that Berlocka might have started with less fuel? His pit stop was a second more than old Marius Myhrvold's was. So that
it could be just what's the word? I can't think of the word. I'm sure the viewers know what I'm thinking of.
Yeah, okay.
A random timer in the pits.
Yeah,
so pit crew. He needs to pay his pit crew a bit more, I think.
Got it, okay. Yeah, needs to pay a little bit more.
Yes.
More holidays.
Stop drinking so much vodka and pay the pit crew.
That's right, yep. Got to pay the pit crew. Well, so now Davis has clear track. This is going to calm his head. Butcher's going to be a little frustrated. There was no fault on Jesper there. I mean, he was a little sideways. Butcher was sideways.
Sideways indeed.
But once you're locked up, there's not much you can really do to avoid a small contact like that.
What's the gap as they cross the line? 27.9 from Toby Davis. It's really dropped off the lap times. Yeah, what if Balak was on the mediums? Because his pace did drop off quite a bit.
Oh, look at Jesper. Oh, jeez. He can't get him into turn one, can he?
No, he can't. But imagine, this really has off that final corner once he gets to turn one. Turn one, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, I know.
He's sideways drifting it.
He can't quite take advantage of it, though. I think he needs to back off a little bit before turn one so that
yes.
he can close in and use the draft
down the
straight.
But he's so good there, though, isn't he? Isn't he good there?
He is. He's so good.
Oh, he's good at drifting there as well. That's not going to help his tires either. Spectacular. It's not helping his tires.
We're coming up on the halfway mark now, and Florian Strauss is in fourth position. Florian Strauss, only
not very far behind that, 9 seconds behind the lead.
7 seconds, no, 6.3 seconds back of Jesper Thalberg. Could Florian Strauss go all the way?
Could he win this if they get involved in battles? He has closed the gap, actually, you know, because the gap was about 13 seconds, I'm pretty sure.
I'm checking
one point
his lap
to him.
Times here. He's running 27 fours, best lap of 26.8. Best lap was by Berlocka of a 26.249. Remember, Berlocka just pitted, so we could see Berlocka kind of just come out of nowhere with stopping early. He's undercutting everyone.
What kind of lap times is Berlocka doing right now?
Berlocka, I'll tell you in a moment here because he the way where his pit stall was, I will know very shortly here. He's on a heater.
Know at the end
right
of his lap. Okay.
He's on a heater.
Oh, Torborg in, storms into the pits.
What's the speed on the pit lane again?
It's about 100 miles an hour.
100 miles an hour?
It was increased to 80 because of the safety aspect of that very dangerous
doesn't
pit
seem
lane
very safe for the pit crews now, does
entry.
It? Oh, look, is that Berlocka? Don't tell me that's Berlocka, is it?
Here's Berlocka. Yes, it's going to be close. You're going to have the... Oh, it's
side
by side with Tavite as well. It's not going to help.
Oh,
Torborg's
okay,
cause
okay.
at all.
Okay, I thought Berlocka was coming up to pass... Jesper.
No, he's quite way behind actually in the end.
Oh, he is. Yeah, he is. I think he lost too much time in that second. He only did it. His pit stop was 9.5 seconds according to the timer.
Oh, to fight sideways. Oh, try not to hit Torborg. That would have been disastrous. Torborg's through, though. That was decisive for Torborg to get past Vike quickly.
Yes.
Here is
Levike,
just 10 seconds off the lead. Very close indeed, actually, to be honest. Strauss is only 8.9 seconds off the lead now. Butcher is gaining on Toby Davis. Look at this. You can see it visibly he's gaining.
Yeah, now he doesn't have that. Now he doesn't have that worry in the mirror. He doesn't have the Iceman all filling up his mirror.
It was 2.3 seconds.
It was
after the incident happened. It's now 1.8 now.
Yeah, Davis looks like he's struggling quite a bit. But yeah, I would expect to see these guys pit probably about the same time. It doesn't really make any sense to try to go. Whoever pits earlier is going to get going to have a better outlap and maybe save some time.
Davis
Butcher
doesn't
in.
Pit.
Butcher's in. So
exactly halfway. Toby didn't pit.
What was the time difference? 1.8?
1.8.
Okay, so let's see what it is when Toby Davis comes out and see if this
is a good
move.
Well, Strauss pits, man. Strauss doesn't pit either.
Strauss is not pitting. Is he not pitting?
Vike doesn't pit.
Oh, you got... No way.
Here is Jesper.
Oh, he almost hit the wall.
Almost hit the wall again, but here is Jesper and Butcher. How close is it going to be? There were nose to tail before. Butcher's out before him.
But no, the big story is, what about Strauss and Levesque?
Yeah, are they? They're way up the field. Actually, look, they're way at the turn.
Look at Levesque, look at him sliding.
Oh, that was beautiful. Kudos to Levesque. The gap between we'll soon find out the gap between Levesque and Butcher. This is Levesque. He's in the Alpha 75 Turbo. Just up the fifth so far in the season at Virginia. He's on for equally in that at the moment over net. I don't think he'll be able to stay ahead of Butcher and Tall Bob.
I don't think Levesque's pace has dropped significantly compared. Well, I guess both Levesque and Strauss are about the same pace right now. They're about a mid to high 27.
And Strauss is matching the pace of Davis at the front.
He is. But Davis is still going. I think, is he going?
Oh, here is, at the final corner, will he pit?
Is he pitting?
Yes, he's in.
He is. Okay,
he's in.
Okay.
Davis
is in. The leader is in.
Let's check on Butcher. Where is Butcher?
Let's follow Butcher.
Gap between Butcher and Tall Bob was 1.3 seconds. So
it was 1.8 between Butcher and Davis as before they pitted. So was it a good move to pit a lap earlier? If his outlap was hot, he should be able to take the lead. If not,
here's Toby.
Close the gap.
Leaving the pits.
8.4 seconds in his pit.
Here is Butcher from his point of view.
Oh, it's a good move.
He's going to have the momentum, but surely. Oh, he's pushed too hard. He's understeered. He just got excited and pushed too hard.
Toby's on cold tires, but he gained a second by pitting early.
Yes. Perhaps that was a calculated gamble by Toby, knowing that he would gain a second, but he had a 1.8 second gap, and he wanted one lap extra fresher tyres.
Wanted it towards the end. It all depends on how hard they're going to be pushing now. We're on lap 23.
Oh, Butcher just got that first turn right. He would have had a chance of the lead.
Yeah, he would have been able to push him down here. But Davis is still on cold tyres, too.
Absolutely.
So this lap, that one little mistake could cost Butcher the race. It could. Talberg's about a 1.1 back, but if these guys battle again, expect to see Talberg.
Talberg's going to be straight
right
there, isn't he? No doubt about
there.
That.
Well, one pass attempt, Jesper's back in the mix.
Yes.
One pass.
Leaping over the curves. Where is Gary Lennon right now?
Gary Lennon's 10th position.
10th position.
What, 16 positions?
Yes.
Unbelievable. And now he's closing in on Adam Vaughan.
Who's in 9th. Myhrvold, Vaughan's great rival, is in 11th.
So actually, if you look, his pace is 28.1 right now. He's faster than all the guys in front of him, and he hasn't
leading the race. Strauss is leading the race. He's not pitting. Neither is Levesque. This could be interesting because these guys might have to pass. Davis and Butcher and Tolbert might have to pass these guys.
They're going to. There's no doubt right now. There's going to be about a second and a half a lap gap. Florian Strauss 28.3. William Levesque 28.6.
The point being though, they have to pass them.
That's they do.
Butcher's made a mistake.
Oh no!
What's up with Butcher? He's gone to the inside of the track.
Oh no! Don't
Something's wrong.
He's having problems again.
Something's wrong. What's he done to his car?
Oh, he's having pedals problem again. Remember, we've talked about this in multiple broadcasts where he lets people by and then he gets going again. He has a pedal problem where all of a sudden he has no throttle input.
I had this in Cleo's once. Is that what happened? It didn't happen at Sebring, remember? Because it was just in the end. It was just him letting. Tallborg through.
He told me that's what it was. There's nothing
really?
More. Yeah. He told me he has problems with the input. Oh, it's so unfortunate.
Oh, it's just died. Look,
it just died.
It just died down the straight.
That's the throttle. His pedals. I told him. I don't know what he can do with it unless he gets new pedals. But that's the problem. It's like it's an intermittent on and off, and he doesn't have the power. And then right there, right down
sick.
The straight.
Sick. Hambalaka now.
Unbelievable. Oh, it's such a shame, guys. I always look shaping
shame.
Up to be a really good battle. So
it's going to be a good battle still, because Tolborg is right behind Davis. And Davis will have to pass Levesque and Strauss to win this
who's
race.
Who's that in front of him there? That's
that's Jonathan Mothram.
Okay, yes.
That marker has been lapped at the moment.
Yep.
He stays out of the way nicely for Tolborg to go through.
So you have your two championship leaders, Toby Davis, Jesper Tolborg. The difference in points, if it ends like this, would end up being 10. It would be 17-point difference between the two of them.
That's just typical of Butcher's, championship, isn't
I know,
it? It happens too often.
It does. It does. It's really unfortunate because Chris Butcher is an extreme talent. He shows it. When anything he drives, he's fast in. It's just he seems to have this unfortunate cloud that hovers over him. You know, I mean, it's very unfortunate because I'd love to see Butcher compete for a championship. I think he's capable of doing it. He just, he gets his composure now, and now he starts having technical problems. It's mm-hmm. just really unfortunate.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, and I'm just being informed it was Clio Euro Series race one, round one, race two. It happened.
Yes, Silverstone. Absolutely, I remember that.
Very unfortunate.
Because I ended up beating him, even though I had a drive through because of that difficulty he had.
So if there's anyone out there that has a spare set of paddles they could send to Chris Butcher at Buchacho Buchacho at at Buchacho.com. Just
Buchacho.macho at Buchacho.com.
Yeah, yeah, and email him and let him know about the spare set of pedals you got, because we'd like to see him compete for a championship.
Absolutely. The more, the merrier. I mean, it's left at Davis and Tolborg again to pick up the pieces, though, isn't it?
It does, it does. And, well, again, we got...
Strauss is pitting.
Strauss is in. Oh, he has the worst pit stall, too.
That's got the worst pit stall. Wow.
That is awful.
I think he must have used grass, because there's plenty of debris there in the background.
Florian Strauss, 8.3 seconds, comes out. Where's he going to fall in? Eric Tavita said, where is Gary Lennon? This is the bat one I want to know.
14th is Gary Lennon. He's had to pit, Lennon, so he's obviously gone backwards.
He lost some spots because of pitting, but he's not far back.
So Davis only has to pass Levite. I don't think Levite's going to pit. Davis will have to pass Levite. Will that allow Tolborg to close the gap? If that allows Tolborg to close the back and Tolborg and Davis battle, will that allow Blaka to close the gap? Therefore, if Blaka's able to close the gap, then Butch will be able to close the gap because he's right behind Blaka. Not over yet, boys.
No, not at all. If this problem with Butcher is going to be consistent, Strauss may actually close with fresh tires. But the big story, Gary Lennon is in right now 14th. Everyone's pitted. He's got Miravol just in front of him. I think Gary Lennon waited too long to pit. I think it would have been in his best interest to pit a little early to get those fresh tires, because mm-hmm. he's lost a lot of the spots that he worked to get past these people. Jay Adji, Jeff Dobbing. He struggled to. Now he's got to get back by him.
He's right behind this group, though. Wow, right behind it. Look at this battle. I wouldn't want to be Miravol right now. Menacing grin of the rover behind him.
Also, just wanted to give a shout out to Bram Hengenveld. He won the RD Open Wheel Championship race today, so congrats for that.
Very nice indeed. He's a key contender for that championship, isn't he? I think he's won two now, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. It's looking good for him. So we just got that.
The old and slow admin is showing he's not so old and slow.
Yeah. So Miravol's got fresh tires. Gary Lennon, Jay Adji, Jeff Dobbing, they're all going to be in a heated battle for the next few laps. There's a four-car train. I think it's fairly spread out here. Is the gap closing at all with... I'll pull it up myself, just follow those guys. But the gap with Davis and...
Less than a second to Levesque. So we're going to go back to the front of the battle now, I think.
This is going to be... Levesque may actually give way
Butcher and Blaka.
So early.
This is reminding me of Virginia. Butcher and Blaka.
It does. Yep.
Had a great race there. And now here is Levesque and Toby Davis. What Tolborg wants is for Levesque to hold up Davis just half a second. Just half a second. Give him the sniff. Davis is right behind the French-Canadian. The final corner they come. Oh, Davis sideways. Will he try and get past in this corner here? If he does, is he really going to hold him up? Oh, almost big contact. Wow. Side by side into turn one, and Davis takes the lead of the race. Davis takes the lead of the race. Off the track there is Tony Matthews, just in the gravel trap on the edge of turn one. Davis passes Levesque with a minimum of a fuss, and that's important to keep his gap between himself and Tolborg.
Oh, look at Levesque!
Oh, Levesque! Once again. I wonder if he's going to have to pit, perhaps, because he's really struggling with those tyres, it seems to me. He's going to drop all the way back to 5th at least. Pitt. Ah, he's going to drop back to maybe 6th. So it's a toss-up for Levesque. Gap between Blaka and Butcher is almost nothing, as you can see. Oh, just get out of the way there. Tony Matthews once again. Tolborg is 1.6 seconds behind Toby Davis now.
I think it was just the move by Levesque that closed it up, because it was actually about, I think it was almost 2 seconds before that happened there. So if Jesper can make a clean pass and maybe get a little draft off of Levesque, I think they're coming on to...
It should be no problem passing Levesque, because he's about to come to the final corner and a little bit of the straight.
Yep.
So this should be the key area where Tolborg goes past Levesque.
Yeah, this should be a fairly easy maneuver, because he's going to get a bit of a draft. Should be able to...
Not going to work, it's too far back.
Oh, look at him close, though.
Oh, it looks so dramatic, that, doesn't it? Every time.
Oh, but you know what? Now that's going to affect his time big time.
Levesque's, well, it's okay, because Levesque can go through the corner as fast as he can.
Yeah, that's true. And they should get them now. And Davis drops a wheel. He's pushing hard.
Yes, they're both pushing hard. Holbrook's in pursuit of Davis.
He's
seen this many times this season.
Yeah, I know. Many, many times. So Davis got to keep his head together. This is for the championship lead. If he lets Jesper, if Jesper manages to catch and pass him, Toby Davis has let the championship lead slip out of his hands. That's simple.
That will be for the first time this season as well.
It will, yeah. It will get, what is this, round six? This reminds me of my ATCC championship.
Where we'll I just not go there, shall we not? We don't want you crying live on air.
I know, I don't want to cry on air. Come on, guys. Come on now.
Just remind people, Levesque has not pitted. That's why these drivers are going past him quite so easily, because got a ruined tyres, but he's not pitting.
Berlocka is definitely going to catch Levesque. Berlocka is definitely going to catch Levesque. Butcher, these guys...
These stop battling it, he will.
Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Held each other up.
So, quickest lap of the race is going to be so far to Berlocka, and I don't think anyone's going to beat that lap.
No.
Because the tyres are a bit worn. We're coming to the end of... coming out of the pits here, the only thing I could see is a potential
more
is...
More traffic.
Yes, more traffic. But more traffic, but also the fuel load getting lighter.
Tolbo crosses the line, and he's lost half a second on that lap. Half a second, that's a lot. He's got Peter Clausen to deal with also as well. It should be a breeze past him on the straight. Oh, he's catching him in all the wrong areas just there, isn't he? And Butcher's got past Berlocka. Let's just watch that on the replay.
Oh, let's see that.
Berlocka almost hit the wall. And Butcher's going to muscle his way past at turn one, I think. Berlocka thought about defending, but I think he knows.
Something happened to Jesper. He dropped back to 2.4 seconds.
Yeah. Oh, there's contact between Butcher and Berlocka as well. Look at that. Wow. Well, hell from Butcher. Yeah, he dropped half a second on the lap before. Torborg. 2.3 seconds now is gap. Gain 0.2 of that first sector. Come up to the second sector now. What is the gap going to be? He's got 11.5 laps to deal with. And he's got people battling in front of him. It's Palmer and Ilivanov. Davis is past them. Gap is still 2.3. Oh, and Tobol's catching them all the wrong areas, it seems. Can't get the brake. Can't get the rubber of the green. Out of the way, gets Ilivanov. Good driving, and Palmer into the pits, and Ilivanov into the pits. Wow, they decided they want to battle for the rest of the race.
I thought maybe they missed the corner. They saw the wall, they just said, all right, I'm pitting.
Gap is 2 seconds, that's a poor lap there from Toby. 27-1 all by himself. Well, it did. Oh, it's Holbrook pushing out as well, he thought, sod it.
Seconds.
Everyone else
is
on the grass, I'm going to do it as well.
Ten laps to go, so yep. What do you think? Oh look at the traffic with Berlocka and Butcher. They're caught up in not too bad. Peter Clausen. He's given room, but it gapped them a little bit. Florian Strauss is
Catch Levesque. He's not a foregone conclusion, you know.
No. Florian Strauss just set his fastest lap of the race, his own personal fastest lap. He is closing like crazy on Berlocka and Butcher. He's in sixth, they're in fifth and fourth. They pitted much earlier than Florian Strauss. So he's got fresh eyes. That's a potential for, which is going to be with, if they can catch Levesque, could be potentially for third position. So Florian Strauss is in a could potentially be in a position for a top three finish after having a horrific start.
And Adam Vaughan has slowly but surely gone about his business, yep. Despite being pushed off the track at one point. He could be up battling for seventh position, definitely.
He could, yes.
Before that incident. And he's a very good race in the end.
Where's our man Gary Lennon? He's back in 13th still. I think he's
still battling. See, he's still in this battle we're about Mirabal. To watch now, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, he's struggling with Mirabal big time.
The camera properly. There we go. And Asnahi is at the head of this battle, which is for 10th between Asnahi,
great
Hadji,
run by him.
Mirabal,
great run.
And Lennon.
That's a great run by Asnahi. He's an incredible run.
Ricardo, his brother's back in 15th, so again, Alberto showing the skills, the bragging rights at the dinner table. You see the difference in the cornering there. And Mirabal's right behind J.A.G. There's one car you don't want behind, it's Alan Marias Mirabal. In that pink power machine. Just a nuisance. Back of the field, Ben Davis is 17, which is a decent performance considering he's had no preparation at all, really, apart from not on the day at least. 18th is Peter Clausen, 19th is Motorum, 20th is Matthews, 21st Palmer, 22nd is Ivanov, 23rd is Jonathan Atherton.
Look at the speed. Oh, jeez.
Atherton on his debut in the series. The rear of the field is gaining valuable experience.
Oh, sideways, actually. Wow. And this is going to give a run to Mervold.
Yep.
Look at this.
He's going to go.
Where's Mervold go? Between the two. He goes straight past them both.
Oh, let's see that. We got to see
is
that
again. Is he through?
Is he through? Did he do it? Oh, God. Oh, he's through.
He's done it.
Two cars.
In one move. Oliver Ryan and Mervold take right a there. Bow. Oh, Adji on Asnahi. They're mugging Asnahi.
Look at this.
Oh, Asnahi's going to be back at him. Asnahi's going to go back at him. Will he go down the inside? Into this corner here. Mervold covers. That was dangerous stuff. I thought it was going to contact Adji in the wall. Look at Gary Lennon goes through. It's taken both of them, look. Side
Gary
by side.
Two. Unbelievable move. Gary Lennon.
Oh, no. He just hit the curb far too hard. What's going to happen there?
So did Lennon get by Mervold? It looked like Lennon's right up on Mervold. He's right up on Mervold. He just passed. So Mervold goes by two. Lennon goes by two. We almost see a car go over. Oh, my Lord.
Passing between two cars on the straight. Three wide down the straight they were.
Berlaka has slowed big time. Strauss is right on his bumper. Something must be wrong with Berlaka. Oh, look at these guys. Sorry, I've just given you nothing.
Polski, doesn't he, Berlaka? Polski,
indeed. Berlaka seems to have slowed right down. I'm not sure what's wrong. He slowed down.
Riven de Haas is not suiting him at all.
He must have taken medium by mistake because he can barely even put the power down.
Oh, that's it. Could be right. Lennon's got the run on Mervold. He's got the low drag. He's got the slipstream.
Rover! Come on.
He dived on the inside. I would do it because Mervold's not going to be able to break as late as he is. Oh, it's close. Oh, it's not quite. It's so difficult to pass that wide machine.
Yeah, it is. It's very difficult.
Gap between Torborg and Davies still 6.1 seconds. Gap between Levesque and Butcher is less than a second. Let's follow that battle now for third position.
For third position, Levesque has not pitted. There's seven laps to go.
This looks like a foregone conclusion, unfortunately.
It is, yes.
Let's see if Levesque can hold off Butcher. Can Butcher just keep his head together and take that third position, take another podium?
Well, I can tell you right now, Levesque is not going to want to give any room. Although, look at the run he's got off here. Levesque's going to go defensive. Butcher's going to go on the outside. He's got the tires to do it. Is he going to do it?
Look at Levesque. Very close.
Oh, very close.
These two guys not far behind this battle at all.
Levesque sideways, all the way through the corner.
Butcher on the outside still.
Oh my God, look at this.
Look at this, so close. Wow. Levesque squeezes across, trying to do what David said earlier in the race. Not good enough. Because Butcher's through into third.
Wow.
And Strauss is up into fifth. Is he? Yes, he is. As he emerged from under the bridge, Strauss is into fifth.
Strauss is in the fifth. Okay, so Strauss's pace is still very quick.
I think he might.
Strauss is going to catch Levesque for a top four. I don't think he's going to get Butcher. Butcher's pace is actually quicker. His last stop was quicker than both the leaders, which is such a shame because, you know, for a technical problem to catch him like that and just have to give up spots, it's really unfortunate. I was looking forward to that battle, because you know that there could have been a battle between Toby and Butcher, and then Jesper takes over, and then we see a shift in the championship. But as is technical problems, it's just something we can't control, right?
Absolutely. These things happen in real life as well as in virtual racing.
Well, look at this. Check this out. Adam Vaughan is closing up on Eric Tveit. Big time.
Oh, this will
back
be.
Eighth and seventh.
Here we are. Battle for seventh. They're all coming together in twos, aren't they, at the end
they
of this
are.
Race?
I like it.
No,
I
third
like
and fourth, fifth and sixth, seventh and eighth.
Yeah, and David Yount is right there, just in case something's
wrong.
He's slowed back a bit by the lap, or he doesn't quite have the room to get by. Oh, look at Vaughan. He's
great.
He's sniffing
great. He's hit in the back of the. Got such a good run. When Tveit changed gear, they almost rammed each other.
One of the speed down the straight to get by.
No, he won't. Just needs to stay close.
Yep.
Oh, mate, Tveit make a mistake like that.
Look at that.
That's going to be a huge accident.
What a move. What a move.
Vaughan goes through, but I thought he was going to come, because of the sideways nature of the car, he was going to go defensive, but Tveit was too quick for him.
Yep. It's and okay. He should be able to hold the outside.
Vaughan, go around the outside.
No, nice. Clean. Oh, contact.
It's close.
Nice. He's got him. He's clear.
Look at that M3 corner ability. It's beautiful.
It just hugs that. It hugs the track.
And there is Tveit right now, right behind
Adam
Vaughan.
Oh, go to Gary Lennon. He was trying to make a move on Mervold, and he just drove off the track. Oh.
Watch down the replay in a second. Oh, Vaughan's got wide. Tveit's on the inside.
Oh, this is the scene of the crime earlier with Adam Vaughn.
Yeah, don't worry about
the fight is close.
Don't worry about
Vaughn needs a couple of good corners just to get the gap on the straight. Otherwise, the fight's going to be right through.
And is that Yun behind? He's closing
Yun right
too.
Behind. He's getting stronger and stronger at the end of the race, isn't he? Oh, look at that! This has changed gear. Look at how close this is. Off the final corner.
Gary Lennon just flipped as Nagy.
Oh, and Vaughn's just gone past Clausen. Try and watch the Lennon Asnari battle in a minute on the replay.
Oh my. Yeah.
Watch Eric Tveit now. He'll have the run because he has the power and the
he's
low
also
drag.
Got the low drag.
This is where Vaughn needs. Oh, he's made a mistake. It's not good enough. He's understand oversteered. Now here comes Tveit. He's got the run. And this time I think it's going to be definitely the pass. There is Adam Vaughn, and Tveit is through. So this battle for 7th place. Now is Yunt involved as well, and that's a real danger to these guys, because
yes,
Yunt, of course,
big time.
Has the power of the Sierra.
Yeah, and just for the guys in the broad, the fans watching, up front it's still pretty quiet. The only thing that may be coming very shortly is Strauss passing Levesque. He's closed in big time. He's only within 8 tenths. This battle here is really good right
gap
now.
Gap between Torborg and Davis is 3.4 seconds.
Yeah, it's close. Toby Davis has taken off.
He has.
Levesque, if you go to hop on board with Strauss, he can smell it right now. And Levesque doesn't have anything to answer with, unfortunately. I mean, it was a good move. I would have loved to have seen Gregory De Greef here racing, because if Levesque is running this well himself without pitting,
yeah.
De Greef would have definitely not pitted, and he would have probably. He's only 10 seconds back.
Yep.
I think De Greef could have probably, if his pace was good, he probably could have won this race, depending on circumstances to do with the race, right?
Here is Strauss looking very threatening, isn't he?
Oh, Adam Vaughn. Oof. Yeah, very sporting. Gary Lennon did let Zanagi back by. It was a light contact that sent his car up and over.
Actually flipped him.
Yeah. Well, it's the same thing like the contact with Vaughn. I saw it as a flip. It may not have showed up
on
the broadcast.
Look at the gain Strauss made through there. Got a real view of his headlights then.
And Dobbing.
Dobbing's had to pit.
Oh, damage.
Big damage. Must have had damage, right? That's
yeah.
A huge
damage. Oh, 63 seconds, yeah.
Wow,
unless he had to go to the bathroom. I know what that's like. I've done it.
Vaughn and Tveit are battling hard also as well. Vaughn's got past Tveit once again. Just stick with this battle for now. This is for fourth.
Yep.
Strauss and Levesque.
I'll update you. I'll update you as if anything changes there. Vaughn's holding the spot. Tveit. Oh,
contact with Tveit and Vaughn off screen. They're watching both at the same time here.
I know. I got both. I don't want to leave this because this is a battle for a top three spot or top five spot here. Oh, this is good.
Will this be the corner where Strauss makes his way through? Oh, he's very, very wide indeed. It's not going to happen.
Oh,
let's go back.
Oh, look at how quick he is through there. Yeah, go back to these guys. Oh, Tveit
yes.
on the inside.
Tveit on the inside. Squeezing. Squeezing up the inside. Oh, side by side once again. And now
Yund
is getting involved. Can he go down the inside of Tveit? No, he can't. Look at the speed that Vaughn has off that final corner, though. He gets such a good run.
I know. He's got such grip. And look, Yund's going to... All he's going to do is just get on Tveit's bumper. Just push him. Push him. Draft him.
Oh, he can't dive on the inside. Here. This is going to end in tears. It's going to end in tears, surely. It's a curve out. Vaughn, how did Vaughn start the car down? He's going straight on.
Oh man, that is unbelievable.
This is a fraught battle, to say the least.
And Florian Schultz has made it by Levesque.
Deja vu. Tveit on the inside of Vaughn once again at turn through two. Oh, Tveit!
This is a battle.
And Vaughn
this
both sideways. Vaughn trying to go around the outside still
he's
trying to go around the outside.
He's got traction.
Not going to happen.
No, not going to happen. Strauss, just an update, Strauss has made it by Levesque, and he's starting to gap a little bit.
From sideways to
this
final corner.
Look at this battle. Oh, Yud!
He's
going to
dive on the inside here, it seems. No, he's not. Tveit! Sideways. Vaughn almost drills him. Yud has to back off as well. Close in the front of his car there to the back. Too hard! Oh, he's so close! Hitting it to Yunt as well.
Wow.
Thought it was going to go over then almost. He hit that curve so hard.
Oh, also, Berlaka has lost a ton of time. We thought he might be able to catch up to Levesque. What we said
no chance.
His car has went off.
Oh, Yunt will be inside!
Sideways.
Sideways again. Oh, Vaughn must be sick of this.
I know. Every time he looks, there's someone in his mirror.
Now he needs to get a good run off this corner, not let Tavai get away.
No, but Yoon's going to have a run, though. Oh, so close to hitting that wall. Every time I see that, every time. You know what, actually, now that I'm looking, Levesque has... Oh, look, he's going.
Look at this. Oh, he's close! Oh, he's just trying to hassle Vaughn into making himself slow through there, and it's worked. It's worked!
Oh, he's wide!
Vaughn is sideways, Yoon's and through, he's going to go, Yoon's.
Vaughn back to nine. Pace. I think Yoon's got the pace to take the right. He seems to be the quicker of the three of these guys.
He seems very strong. Very strong at the end of this race, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's in very good form right now. Very good form. But just a note that Levesque is not letting Strauss go. He is not letting him go.
He is right behind him.
He is. And this Levesque has not pitted once. Strauss may be on mediums, and they might start to be going on him. But it can't be anywhere near as bad as what Levesque's dealing with right now.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, look at this battle. Unbelievable at the moment. This is for seventh. Oh, Tavai's gone off. He's made a mistake.
Oh, no, Vaughn.
To the back of him. And Vaughn spins around. It's another spin by Vaughn in this race. He gets going once again. He might be ahead of Myhrvold. No, Myhrvold comes through. Oh, that's his worst nightmare. Myhrvold coming through. Let's see what happened there.
Just that corner seems to get everyone.
Tavai just went wide, got the power on, and then hit Yunt, and then Vaughn. Nowhere to go. Hits the back of him. Spins around.
Nothing. Oh, battles here, yeah.
Battle for seventh now is between Yunt and Tavite. And Tavite right behind David Yunt. But Yunt seems like he's got the pace and the power. And now he has the high ground, of course.
So, after all said and done with all that, it does kind of spread the field out a little bit with that. Because that was the battle going on. But Adam Vaughn's now battling with Myhrvold, which is going to probably drive him insane.
Yes, it will.
It's just worn tires. Yeah, he's probably sick of seeing that pink machine.
I'm absolutely sick of it.
Absolutely sick.
He spoke
of
to me after the Norris race. He was sick of the pink Holden coming past him all the time on this race.
But Gary Lennon, he had a... Okay, the incident I told you about earlier, he was in the draft of Myhrvold coming up. They were battling for... he was 11th, Myhrvold was 10th. And he just, going into the corner we're watching right now, he just outbraked himself, went wide, dropped the wheel, and went way off into the sand once he lost traction. And that sent him back quite a ways, and now he's... back in 12th, a minute 12 behind the leader.
You've seen the damage on the front of Adam Vaughan's car. It looks like it's got...
That was
look at the speed through there. Wow. look at this. Oh, he's hit that curb hard again. He's lopsided frown on him at the moment.
I love watching the M3 corner. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's beautiful to drive. Absolutely beautiful. 3.8 seconds now the gap between Davis and Torborg at the front of the field. Davis, once he got that gap, and Torborg and Butcher made a small contact, he's been superb, hasn't he?
Well, here's the short long of it here. After his pits, he's been pretty well...
He looked after his tyres this time, hasn't he? Looked after his tyres in the second stint. Yeah. No doubt about that.
His last third, he's done in his last like six laps, 26.9, 27.1, 27.4, 27.3, 27.8, 27.2. So one mistake in six laps. That's how when you get a gap, you take advantage of it and you win the race. That's what he's doing.
It snowballs, isn't it? You look after your tires, they give you more speed. You get more speed, you don't make a mistake, you look after your tires. And,
absolutely.
You know, that's the way it is.
Well, he's 4/10 quicker than anyone else right now on the track. So this is coming up to the last lap here. We're starting the last lap, so maybe we want to give Toby his
Oh, Toby's just won. Sorry. Was there another lap to go? Toby's won the race. My apologies for everybody there. Andy Climax. But Toby Davis reasserts his championship status as the leader and the one to beat. He takes his third win of the season. That's his first win since the second round at Sebring. This is the eighth race. And Torborg takes second to keep the pressure up. Butcher, an unfortunate third. Davis is doing donuts in the middle of the field. Surely you'll appreciate that. Butcher shows him what he thinks of it. And Butcher, unfortunately, takes that third position. Very unlucky there. Strauss in fourth. Levesque in fifth. Another fifth place for Levesque. Very pleased with that. Balaka finished in sixth. Here is Balaka. Seventh place, coming across the line. David Yunt sees off the battle between him and Eric Tveit. Crosses the line in 7th. 8th place will be Eric Tveit. Really drops off at the end there. 9th place is going to be Myhrvold. And 10th place is going to be Adam Vaughan with an incident-packed race. 11th position to J.I.G. 12th place is going to be Gary Lennon. To fight him back from the back of the field. Looks like he may get further up at one point. but he does cross the line in 12th.
Yep, well, very, very good run by Gary to come back. He made up 14 positions, which is a phenomenal run. He very well could have had a ninth position because he was battling with Myhrvold, and that would have been an incredible feat in this field.
And 13th place, Alberto Asnahi. He ends up being beaten in the M3 Honours in the end by Adam Vaughan. So, Tobe was the best Sierra, Torborg the best Holden, Strauss the best 635, and Levesque the best Alfa Romeo. And but I think that was a great second stint there from Toby Davis, wasn't it, Keith? He really controlled the race afterwards.
Yeah, I mean, once he didn't have the pressure on, he could focus. And I mean, like I said, in the last six laps of the race, he made one mistake. That's it. Mm-hmm. Like one little off, and that was it. So, I mean, he just established that he's the championship leader, and he's looking to win this championship and take it down. So,
absolutely.
I mean, very well done by him. And I believe we're joined now by Toby. So
we are. We're joined by the race winner and the championship leader. Just describe the race to us, Toby. It was a very, very intense first stint, but the second stint, you just put your head down and really pulled away.
That's the hardest I've ever had to work to get a win, and mm-hmm. Quite frankly, it was for the entire first stint, it was just 22 qualifying laps, and it was after the pit stop, it was another 10 just to gap Talborg, who looked very strong.
Then in the second stint, was it decisive that you were able to just drive your normal lines in the second stint and just look after your tyres? Because the first stint looked like your tyres were going away earlier than they usually do. In the second stint, you looked like you were able to keep the tyres together much easier.
As I said, I had to push 100% through every single lap mm-hmm. Through the first stint. And Butch was drafting me almost every single time into the long right-hander, turn 2, 3, whatever you want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
And so back every lap either. I had to make a defensive move there. And it was costing us time. But Laka managed to get a double slipstream off us and steal the fastest lap as well, which I was a bit annoyed about with it. There we go.
Well done to you. And how does it feel to take your first win since spring? Was the win the streak worrying you, or were you happy with the consistency so far?
Well, Talborg jumped in practice with some excellent laps, race pace laps that we thought were race pace, myself and Chris. So we were a little bit more worried than we were before. I'm very happy to have taken almost maximum points from Lusitana, and heading into Potrero, hopefully I'll be able to extend the gap as well.
It will be a lottery at Potrero, but well done on keeping. On stopping the rot, as it were, because yes. Talborg has been gaining hand over fist over the last five races, and Toby's managed to push away.
17 points off of my poor masculines, but you have, according to that, a 17-point lead headed into the seventh round of WTM, so well done, man. That's what you needed headed into the next race, because it's going to be a close battle to the end of the season.
And well done to you, Toby. Now, we'll move on to Chris Butcher, who finished in third position but had a real chance of winning the race. Chris, what happened? What was the problem? Was it throttle pedal again?
No, something completely different this time. The I don't really know what to call it, but the thing that keeps my pedals in place broke during the race.
Oh, no!
And literally, I mean, obviously, it was starting to happen just as Toby came out of the pit lane. And I would have had a go at him on the brakes, but I really wasn't confident because every time I hit the brakes, the pedals were moving away. And then when you saw me slow down, it had got to the point where if I'd gone into that turn, I wouldn't have had any braking, so I kind of had to move it and lost about 8 seconds, was it? Something like that. So, yeah.
That was very unfortunate indeed. But you had a fantastic battle in the opening part of the race. Did you ever, you know... Did you ever think that you would definitely get past Toby at one point? I mean, was there certain moments when you thought, yes, I'm past?
Yeah, definitely, especially in that turn 3 or turn 2, whatever you want to call it.
But, yes.
there was some very, I felt harsh defending from Toby, but I won't comment any further on that.
It seemed hard but fair from our point of view as spectators, and there didn't seem anything completely untoward.
But I think I had the pace over him.
Yeah, it seemed like he did.
Tiny bit better, I think, considering the gap that closed up after the pit stops. But, you know, what can I do?
Well, Chris...
Go ahead, Keith.
I just wanted to just point one thing out, Chris. I was commenting in the race that, you know, you've really kind of grown racing, and I mean I said the same thing at the last event. This particular event, you looked like, to me it looked like you were able to win the race. I really thought that you had a good shot of winning the race today. And I was saying that, you know, you, in seasons past, you've overcome you know, making mistakes on your own. Now you're suffering technical issues. It's very unfortunate. You know, but do you feel you've grown as a racer, and you think you can compete for a championship if these little things stop happening to you?
I think so. Yeah. Hopefully, if there's a season 4 of WTM, then maybe that'll be the time.
Right on. Well, that's what we were saying. We think season 4 of WTM, you will be definitely one of the contenders for the championship. So, well done today, and we look forward to seeing you race in the next round.
Thank you. Now,
Jesper, I know you're not a big fan of the interviews, but I just wanted just a quick word with you. How did you feel that race went for you? I know the Holden wasn't it was a tough car to be racing here at this track because of the long sweeping corners. Did this race go as well as you could have hoped?
Yeah, I think so. A race win would be nice, but Toby was just too fast.
Okay, that's kind of what we felt and saw. I mean, you had that great pace at the start of the race, but also I think that that also relies on the fact that there was some battling going on because your car is definitely not the car of choice at this track with the tire wear. But do you feel you have a good shot coming through the seventh round and the eighth round? You're only 17 points back, which is not a huge gap considering how far back you were at the start of the season. Do you feel you have a good chance to win the championship still, Jesper?
Well, it's still possible, but the next track is wet, so I don't know how the Holden's gonna be there.
Okay, well, that's fair enough, but we look forward to seeing your race next race. So well done today, Jesper.
Yeah, just quickly before we talk to William Levesque, the next two races, as Jesper mentioned just there, briefly mentioned, was the next race is wet at Potrero. You've got two mountain races coming up, so you've got Potrero de las Fuentes. And we've got Mount Panorama as well, of course, to finalise our round. We all know what happened to Toby Davis last time at Bathurst, so it's still all to play for there. My apologies to Toby for bringing that up once again. But Potrero is going to be in a completely unknown quantity because we're going to be in the wet. And how the Holden will be in the wet is anybody's guess, really. And anything could happen into the first turn of that sort of track. And it's a very long track also as well, so we're looking for some great fireworks there. It's a first in... the TPS actually to have a wet race in R Factor. That's the very first time we'll ever have it. So we're looking forward to that in 2 weeks' time. But moving on to William Levesque quickly. An excellent fifth place again for you, William, equaling your best results.
Yeah, that was the end for. I hope it was entertaining.
It was.
I was so sideways everywhere.
Yeah,
but
we could see.
I'm going to keep my strategy. Well, I don't know what all the wets are going to do regarding tire wear, but. Nonetheless, I'm pretty happy with the result, and I couldn't hope for best.
Well, very well done to you, William. And we mentioned in the broadcast, you've really grown over the past year as a sim racer. You've got better and better and better. Very impressive, and you keep getting impressive results. So very well done to you.
Thanks.
And we'll look out for you at Potrero, of course, as well, because you will have one of the better handling cars at Potrero, which is going to be a low grip surface because of that wet. And thank you guys for joining us for the interview, and thank you for entertaining us on track also as well.
Yes, well done, everybody.
Yeah, well done, guys.
Yeah, well done. So, Ryan, exciting again. I mean, I was exhausted about maybe ten laps into the race. I was ready to go take a nap.
Lap five for me.
Yeah, lap five. Well, I mean, plus we've been working really hard getting everything sorted out with Touring Pro Series, our website, you know, getting that launched and everything. But this race just, you know, it just keeps the bar where it always has been with WTM, and I think we've got a really good championship battle on our hands. Obviously, Holden.
Oh, I love this. I love this battle. It's so close.
It is. It's very close.
And there's been no problems for anybody at all. It's all been no technical issues. It's all been on track, which is lovely.
Well, except for Chris Butter, but that's just the...
Well, I mean, the battle between Torborg and Davis.
Oh, yes, yes, true, yeah. And I think it's... I know the Holden's probably going to be a little disadvantaged in the wet, but, you know, Toby has in the past been a little mistake-prone, and now that it's going to be wet, You know, is that going to, you know, maybe bring back some of that, those little mistakes that Toby can make? Because perhaps driving in the wet is not easy. Any lapse in judgment or lapse in your thinking and have an incident and you could lose 5, 10, 15 spots. I mean, lap one, you spin out, you're in a lot of trouble. And it's just going to be exciting. So anyone watching, make sure you tune in. We got two more rounds left at WTM. Make sure you join us and follow along with the chat. Make sure you get to touringproseries.com and follow along there as well, too.
Absolutely. Touringproseries.com. We've just been launched, and it's full of lovely, lovely content. Going to be filled with even more content very soon.
Yes.
As soon as me and Keith pull our fingers out. No, yeah. We've been working very hard over the past couple of weeks on the site to get it good looking for you guys, and hopefully you do enjoy it. It's going to be a figurehead four-hour series. Again, the forum is staying at Race Department. There's no problems there, and we will stay there. And well, just thinking of Bathurst, Keith.
Yes.
We know how good Jesper is there.
Yes.
He's had a double win there in the ATCC in season 3.
Yep.
The Clinton Championship. He won there eventually in WTM season 2.
Yes.
Against Peter Davilar. And last time Toby went to Bathurst, he's binned it both times.
He did.
In the same area.
Same spot, and now it's going to be wet.
Bathurst won't be wet.
Oh, just I apologize. Sorry.
Just Potrero wet.
Yes. No. I mean, Bathurst is always a game changer, and, cooler heads will prevail there. And if the championship stays within a 20-point gap headed into Bathurst, you very well could see the championship decided there in the last race.
It's a lot of laps for drivers to do without making a mistake.
Yes,
and
it is.
And Toby's done it in the same area in the last two races he's been there. The World V8 Supercars 2011,
yep.
He ripped off the front end of his car. And in WTM, he didn't end his race, but he pretty much ruined his race.
Yes.
And disconnected in the end anyway, but it was academic. But still, that's going to be perhaps a demon in the head, do you think, Keith?
Oh, of course. I mean, you can't forget stuff like that that's happened. I mean, I'm terrified to head to Laguna Seca, but when you make mistakes in the past, the hardest thing to do is to get over them and the places you've made them, because you're either going too slow through them or you're going to make the same mistake again. So finding that middle ground is what he's going to have to do. He's shown that he's capable of stepping up this season. So, I mean, I'm very confident that he can pull it off. Just
the pressure he withstood today was excellent, wasn't it? It was phenomenal pressure. And he drove superbly.
Yeah, he did. Phenomenal. It was the only question in my mind is if Chris Butcher didn't have that problem, would it have changed the entire result of the race? Would they have battled? Would there have been slight contact? Would Jesper maybe have taken the win? But tis racing.
But the key thing there is that Toby took advantage immediately. Took advantage.
Yep. Yeah, he just put his head down, started doing
the opportunity.
Yeah, and it's been for the entirety of this season, it's been don't let Toby get out front. That's every single race we've said that. I'm pretty sure we've said it every single race. And
yep.
he got out front with no one behind him, and look what happened. So, well on him. If the season ended today, he would be a worthy champion for sure.
Excellent. And so that wraps up our World Touring Masters coverage. What's happening on Friday, Keith?
We are headed to round two of the American Touring Car Championship, brought to you by Touring Pro Series, supported by Race Department. We'll be racing at Watkins Glen GP, which has basically been a mainstay in the league. It was our pre-qualifying track for season 2, and some of the big names that were in season 2 and did well there are also again going to be in season 3 and racing there. And it's going to be I think it's going to be even closer than it was last season. We had a few unfortunate things happen in round 1, a couple of incidents that we took care of, but
we're looking forward to cleaner round 2, aren't we?
That's well. Definitely. I mean, we brought the hammer down on the racers strictly because we needed to prove a point that the racing, the incidents that happened were not acceptable. And if the racers need to do their due diligence and race cleanly, I expect Watkins Glen to be one of probably the best races that we'll be able to put on live in the season. It's a great track to race at. People can race very close with our new server. There's little to no lag at all. So make sure you tune in. It's going to be this Friday, 9:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, or it'll be Saturday at 2 a.m. GMT for the Europeans who love to stay up real late and watch us. And Ryan and Toby will be doing comms. And I'm looking forward to watching that broadcast back because I think it's going to be an epic race.
Well, last time out, NATO and VR were the two race winners, the Team Portugal teammates.
That's right.
So, and VR is second in the championship at the moment, right behind Jesper Torborg.
Jesper Torborg, season 2 champ.
Season 3 champ. And in the first season, where this is the third time we go to Watkins Glen, we came here in season 1 on the NASCAR layout.
Yep.
Season 3 went to the Watkins GP layout where NATO and VR won. In season 1, Lawson and Boucher won. So there's a couple of names from the past.
Yes, definitely. They no longer race with us, but they are in the TPS history for sure.
And a key bit of trivia, of course, is that Rhys Gardner's only two pole positions in the Touring Pro Series have come both at this track. Both times we've raced at Watkins Glen, Rhys Gardner has taken pole position. So look out for fireworks from him as well. So we might see a surprise pole sitter.
That's right. Well, it may not be a big surprise if he's already got two, so...
I guess so. I remember Bjorn last season was... his eyes seemed like they fell out of his head when he saw that Rhys Gardner was on pole position in that Volvo 60.
Well, it was a good show today, Ryan. Thanks for having me again. I'm always glad to work beside you in the booth, so...
No problem, Keith. Pleasure to have you here. And thank you to everyone for watching also as well. And we'll see you on Friday for the second round of American Touring Car Championship. Well, I'll be your host again alongside with WTM Championship leader Toby Davis as the analyst. So we can't get better than that, can we, Keith?
No, we cannot.
Okay. Thank you, guys, for watching. See you on Friday.